Looks like we've got an active distress beacon on the planet below, Commander. No message, just a locator signal.
Ready.
Yes, ma'am.
En route.
Heading out.
Strange. The Geth are attacking, and everyone around here is still worried about ordinary business.
It's politics, Williams. The Council won't raise the alarm until they're certain about the threat.
The threat? Did they not see the vids of Eden Prime? See, this is why I hate politics.
Kill them all!
Kill them all!
Negative contacts, Commander.
Rescuers? Oh, thank God. See? I told you somebody would come to investigate that signal. My name is Dr. Ross, Chief Exogeny Researcher at this facility. We've been trapped in this room for days. We're almost out of food and water. You got here just in time.
Not so fast. First you're gonna tell me why this place is overrun with Thorian creepers.
How do you know about the Thorian?
I know what Exogeny was up to. I saw what they let the Thorian do to those colonists, so I destroyed it.
Our secret's out then. No point in my lying. You already know the worst. The creepers here were created using altered samples from the specimens on Pharos. We discovered a way to turn them into docile, obedient servants. Everything was going fine until a few days ago. Then all the creepers suddenly went berserk. Only a handful of us made it back into the safety of this room.
Why didn't you send a clear message asking for help? All we had was that signal from the emergency beacon.
This is a closed communications base. Exogeny was worried about someone on the project selling secrets to a rival firm or reporting our work to the authorities. We have no direct communication with the outside, only the emergency beacon. It sends a general distress signal to the Exogeny site on Pharos. They're supposed to send a team to respond inside of 24 hours, but it sounds like they had problems of their own.
Any chance some of the other people at the base might still be alive?
I doubt it. Too many creepers out there. They never stood a chance. We're the only ones left.
Any idea why they turned on you?
Maybe there was still some kind of link between the creepers and the Thorian back on Pharos. The Thorian was unlike any other life form we've ever studied. I can't explain how, but maybe when it died, it somehow set off the creepers here.
I've heard all I need to.
Look, I know what we did here was wrong. I'll admit that. But it's over now. There's no sense reporting this to the authorities, right?
Too many people died here. Their blood is on your hands.
Be reasonable. I didn't mean for this to happen. Besides, how does it help anyone if I end up in jail? Normally Exogeny would have my back, but it sounds like they're going to have their hands full cleaning up the mess on Pharos. But I've got money. A nice little emergency fund I set up. It's yours if you let us go.
This isn't about money. It's about justice. Blood for blood.
That's not going to happen. Open fire. Open fire!
Go, go, go!
That's it. Bag him and tag him.
Thank you.
Rescuers? Oh, thank God. See? I told you somebody would come to investigate that signal. My name is Dr. Ross, Chief Exogeni Researcher at this facility. We've been trapped in this room for days. We're almost out of food and water. You got here just in time.
Not so fast. First you're gonna tell me why this place is overrun with Thorian creepers.
How do you know about the Thorian?
I know what Exogeni was up to. I saw what they let the Thorian do to those colonists, so I destroyed it.
Our secret's out then. No point in my lying. You already know the worst. The creepers here were created using altered samples from the specimens on Pharos. We discovered a way to turn them into docile, obedient servants. Everything was going fine until a few days ago. Then all the creepers suddenly went berserk. Only a handful of us made it back into the safety of this room.
What did you expect? You couldn't really believe those things were safe.
We knew there were risks, but I thought we'd taken all the necessary precautions. I didn't mean for this to happen. Look, I know what we did here was wrong. I'll admit that. But it's over now. There's no sense reporting this to the authorities, right?
You were in charge of this project. The safety of the staff was your responsibility. They trusted you, and you betrayed that trust.
Be reasonable. I didn't mean for this to happen. Besides, how does it help anyone if I end up in jail? Normally, Exogeni would have my back, but it sounds like they're going to have their hands full cleaning up the mess on Pharos. But I've got money. A nice little emergency fund I set up. It's yours if you let us go.
Deal. Get the hell out of here.
You made the smart choice, Commander.
According to the log files, the ship was out near the Perseus Vale. Looks like they found some kind of alien artifact. They brought it on board, and then... this doesn't make any sense. They plotted a course straight into the Perseus Vale, like they wanted the Geth to find them.
That artifact must have done something to them. Why else would someone fly into Geth space?
The entries don't make a lot of sense after that. It's like the captain's mind was falling apart. Doesn't say anything about how the ship got back into human territory.
The Geth turned them into husks and left the ship where someone would find it. Trying to show us what happens to organics dumb enough to enter the Vale.
With all this exploration of Provian culture, this must be like a survey for you, Liara.
Our travels now are somewhat different from my normal excavations. I would prefer lengthier studies and fewer explosions.
Yes, most of the technology I had hoped to bring back to the flotilla has subsequently attempted to kill us.
Thank you.
there is a Yuri.
I've got a bad feeling about this. How horrible. The entire colony must have been transformed.
Finally, some action! Perimeter clear. That's it. Bag 'em and tag 'em.
These logs place the blame for this on a group called Cerberus, whoever they are.
You lead. I'll follow.
Ready.
Thank you.
heading to position.
Say the word.
Got it.
Now it gets fun!
Clear.